How will you lower food costs?
The problem in the Philippines today is that we lack infrastructure. Kung mahirap ang daan, and there's no roads at all, and people have to buy goods from the outside of the province or city, the freight alone will kill you. At kung walang magandang daan, mas magastos. Kasi mas maraming gasolina ang gamitin. And one other also is yung mga checkpoints ng police. Kasi kung magbigay ka sa mga checkpoints, ultimately, itong nalugi nila na pera o inibigay nila dyan sa kung ano-ano ang mga checkpoints dyan sa highway, itacharge doon yan sa consumer. Dapat mawala rin yan. Dapat ang daan maganda at mabilis. You know, in the law of supply and demand sa economics, ang habulin ng mga negosyante is how to transport their business from one place to the other fastest, kagaya ng isda, then the cheapest, o kagaya ng may infrastructure ka. If there's a road there, you do not have to double your expense sa gasolina. And the safest. Safe yung pagdala mo sa goods from one province to another. Yan ang rule ng economics. You transport the goods because there is a law of supply and demand. Certain goods are needed in another place. Or merong isa dito, ikaw yung nag-export sa ibang bayan. You'd go for the cheapest, the fastest, and the safest. Well, one factor really is the craving for profit. Bibilihin ng mga middlemen. Kaya yun nga galit ng mga komunista dyan, yung comprador, because they double the price and also because of the checkpoint, kung anong bilihan nila, kung anong bigyan, and they will add it up to the consumer eventually. Yan ang nangyayari dyan. Everybody wants to make a living, some borrow, some of their own capital. But for the ordinary poor Filipino, he goes to borrow money from the sharks. Loan sharks. At yung tatawag na 5-6 dito sa Pilipinas. And you add up to the price of the goods that you're selling, plus yung nawawala mo sa checkpoints, and eventually, it is the consumer that suffers. Yun ang problema niya. There has to be a way where the land bank, DBP, or other government financing institutions can lend money to the poor so that they can avoid the 5-6. So we must put mga bagsakan, food terminals, and the people can have a choice of going to the supermarkets to buy at a higher price o sila ang pumunta doon sa mga bagsakan for a lower cost sa pagkain. Dapat mapahiram natin, maibigyan natin ng mga loans ang ating mga farmers at fishermen para naman na makikita sila and they can have a livelihood at the same time, they can sell their products at a lower cost for everybody. If we can do away with the hindrances, the obstacles, and we are able to create the infrastructure, I aim to lower the food cost in your table by almost 25% to 50% within a year. This is the real trickle-down economics.
What about education?
To do this, we must promote value education. Our government, TV, radio, and mass media, all the resources should be able to concentrate on educating our children, building character, and we must teach the values of hard work, ethic, honesty, cleanliness, self-respect, and the molding of character. Of self-reliance. Discipline that have started in Davao is now being enforced by the people themselves. I have proven that it can be done. We must be innovative. If there are still lack of craftsmen, and we can rely on technology, for example, big screens, or in the meantime, to teach our children the education that they need. Lastly, we must do our work with dignity. We must be able to realize that to progress materially and spiritually, we must be proud of ourselves and learn the dignity of labor and to respect everybody's jobs. Pride and love of country and dignity will be the spiritual force that will move this country to progress economically and to attain stability and finally, in the fullness of God's time, eliminate poverty. So, anong inintay natin? Upakan na natin.